the Hands of Our Girls campaign has created an immense impact on young girls. One, first of all, they now know between right touch and wrong touches. They now know what to do, where to go if somebody is abusing them improperly, if somebody takes advantage of them. They now go to FSU, they now go to Ministry of Social Welfare. So because of the Hands of Our Girls campaign, young girls have become so aware of themselves. They now know the value of their bodies. They know that they should be able to keep their bodies safe away from young men, and they know that they should go to school to empower themselves. Not only so, we also see that the Hands of Our Girls campaign has really taken advantage of the opportunity to protect girls in a way that men are so scared to come close to girls who are below the age of 18 now. We see around town, people do say, "And that is Fatima's daughter, don't touch her."
So we all have to join hands to look after, protect and guide our young ones, our children, but especially the girls. Because when they get married, they cannot do much. When they get married, they go and have children, and this is what leads to fistula most of the time. When they get married, they cannot progress. But then when they get married and they have children, they're not even in a position to be able to teach their own children what the right things are. So let us join hands to make Sierra Leone better. Let us join hands with the First Lady to make this work.
I see in the future that we partner with the First Lady's office in raising the awareness against rape and other sexual violence, and also to improve on girls' education.
So being able to end child marriage, being able to build on what the president is doing for free quality education, we know education is power. We know that if young girls are not married off at an early age, if they are allowed, as we say in UNFPA, to fulfill their full potential. We have a campaign of Hands of Our Girls that is not the First Lady's campaign. It is the people's campaign. It is all of us, our campaign. And for me, I'm absolutely delighted because in UNFPA, we have a program to end child marriage globally. And so now what the First Lady is doing is really helping us achieve our own goal in UNFPA of zero gender-based violence against women and girls.
The laws should be implemented to letter. If you rape certain age, it is there. If you go to the constitution, what we have just passed, you can see the results, you can see the penalties, and we are going to enforce it. If you rape any child that is underage, you will definitely go for life imprisonment.
Save the children. We want children to survive, learn, and be protected. And this campaign covers all three. So if we want to empower girls, they need an opportunity to have a full childhood. They need an opportunity for an education, and their children need an opportunity for all those things too. They need a mother who has the time and the attention and the resources. So this campaign can make a real difference across the board. And not just for women either, for men also. So I think it's important also for the men and boys to realize that having an empowered wife makes such a difference. Having an empowered wife means a stronger family.
I call on all partners to support the Hands of Our Girls campaign in order to ensure that all girls in Sierra Leone grow in an environment free of violence and inequalities to enable them to achieve their full potential in line with the government's human capital development agenda.
I say to our paramount chiefs in particular, the First Lady, together with the Ministry of Social Welfare, we have handed over the campaign to them. I appeal that as they promised, they should keep to their promises and make sure that they use all their powers, particularly early child marriage, and make sure that every sexual penetration or rape case is reported. Our religious leaders, I say, preach this to your congregation. Your voices are so powerful in your different churches and your mosques.